Hello everyone and welcome to the Extreme TIG channel. So for today's video, guys, I'm working on some project, a 30 inch SCAD 40 stainless pipe, 310 material. The prep is not great, pipe is in really bad shape, oval egg shape, lots of high low. This is the best we can get. I was trying to maintain 1/8, 532 all the way around, but it is what it is. So for the purge, I'm using the liquid argon. The flow meter is pretty much maxed out. I'm only using two hoses for the supply for purge. And I got bridge tacks. I'm gonna put a aluminum foil all the way around and leave the vent on the top. Usually I go 15-20 minutes for purge time. If you don't use any purge eye or oxygen monitor, so you can check for your oxygen levels inside, usually 15 minutes should be good enough. I mean, as soon as you strike an arc, you're gonna see how the puddle behaves, if it's good. If you're not sure, you can always stop, check inside with your flashlight. So for the root pass, 120 amps, that's the beginning. That's my initial for 1/8 for tungsten and cup size 8. So you can do whatever it's easier for you, walk the cup on your root pass or freehand. In this case, I'm gonna freehand. I always like to do freehand, it's pretty much a habit for me. With the freehand, I got a little bit better control over my feed hand and my material, how much I'm depositing in. So I kind of slow down here this footage just to show you what's going on. As soon as you connect those edges and make a bridge, try to keep that rod constantly connected to your puddle. The whole idea with the freehand, especially on the overhead section, you want to have enough meat inside on your root, so for the later for the next step in your welding, and that's a hot pass. You don't want to have any suck backs. As I said, with the freehand, kind of a little bit better control over your puddle. You can actually see how much you're depositing in. I'm using 1/8 filler wire. I like 1/8 on a little bit bigger gap on the bottom, so I can actually, that's why I go 120. That's maybe a little bit too much for some welders, but with 1/8, that's a really good amperage, because you wanna put lots of meat, especially as I said, on the bottom section. And then once I reach 8 o'clock, 8-9 o'clock, then I'm just gonna lean on my cup in a bevel and just walk the cup for the rest of the pipe, for the rest of the root. Try to keep it, as I said, that rod constantly connected to your puddle as you're burning edges. Just side to side motion with your torch hand, and the rod is pretty much always like in the edge, on the edge, on the top of that puddle. You don't want to push it like too much inside. You can see like it's kind of, when you lose connection, you can always add it back in into the puddle. Nice and slow, no rush. Take your time. Okay, now we're gonna check for the root, and that's a good solid root. There's lots of meat inside. It's not perfect. That's because when you're doing overhand, that's what happens. Your filler rod is a little bit wobbly inside. So as long as the edges are burned, as long as you got lots of meat inside, everything should be all right. That should be good. You shouldn't be worried for the next step, and that's a hot pass. So later I'm just gonna continue on. But before that, I'm gonna do some commercial for my TIG sleeve. Hey guys, let me introduce you to TIG sleeve. This is TIG rod storage tube, a special design for TIG welders. Every unit is handcrafted, features an O-ring seal to protect your TIG rods from moisture, dust, and any damage. It's 7 inches in length, so it's gonna fit full-size TIG rods.
weighing just 2.6 pounds with a 10 pound rod capacity. Strap it over your back to stay mobile and hands-free while you're climbing. Crawling comes in 5 different colors, and you can check it out on TIGsleeve.com.
So for your tie-in start point, just weight go a little bit below, and just weight preheat. Make sure when it's liquid enough, then you can add the wire. The thing with the stainless, as many of you know, shrinks a lot, so you always gotta leave a little bit more tolerance. You know, if you're aiming for 1/8, go with 5/32, and etc. Of course, you don't want to go to 1/2 inch, but the ideal is actually with stainless 3/32 wire. I use 1/8, that's why I gotta go up on a amperage, especially on the for the bottom section. Once you pass that 9 o'clock, it's easy. The pipe is gonna shrink. In this case, there's lots of high low spots, and the pipe already starts shrinking. I'm gonna show you later in the video. The pipe shrinks a lot, so you can't even feed 1/8 rod. I didn't take a grinder, then you gotta wait for purge again to push all that oxygen out that was created from the grinder itself. That's why I don't like to use grinder. I try to eliminate use of grinder as much as I can. That's why I'm TIG welding, so not much grinding. But yeah, as I said, once it passed that 9 o'clock, now it's actually walking the cup on your root pass. It's way easier. I'm still 120. As you can see, I have to speed up a little bit because the sides are opening. So I'm actually pushing on a day section. I'm actually pushing that filler wire quite a lot. The pressure, not so pressure, but the argon, the purge inside is actually pretty good. As I said, I only got 2 lines, and I got like 8 holes on my dam that's actually purging that entire weld area. So it's a really good coverage. But if it's a little bit bigger gap, you always, of course, adjust, go down 5. Okay, now for this part, so there's one section, top section left on this side, and then I still got the other side. So there's the issue with the high low here. As you can see, that's quite a lot. It's like 4 mil. As I said, this is the best like we could do. The prep is really bad itself. It should be transition ID inside, or but then you lose your wall thickness, so it's kinda, that's what happened when you, no offense to anyone, that's what happened when you ordered cheap pipe from China. No offense to anyone, I mean to Chinese. But they got good stuff as well, so it's all about money. How much you pay, that's what you get. Okay, now for the top section, as I said, that part that was a high low, I go down like 10 amps, I'm around 100 amps. Keep that rod line in the middle and just melting both sides. I can see like both edges are opening, and they covered with the filler material. Everything's easier once you get on the top. Once you get on the top, you can pull it out. I'm holding that, as you can see here, I'm dipping that rod like above, not inside, not on the edge, before that edge, as gravity works the rest. it's gonna push that puddle inside. I got a good coverage, good purge, so it's not gonna be any grapes. It'll be nice and uniform. If you go too much with amps, and then it's gonna open more, you don't want that. Then you gotta feed a lot, you gotta work a lot. Just once you fine tune, you know, your feeding hand and your amps and your travel speed, should work pretty good. As you can see, even here, it's like the material is opening like crazy on one side, because it's a high low. You don't see it here very well on the video, but that's when you get high low, that's why one side is opening, you cutting. That's why I gotta be careful with your torch inclination. As you can see here, this is the other side I was talking about. It's really tight, so imagine now from almost 532, it's down to like what, not even two mil gap. So I'm not going to use grinder, I'm just going to go up 150 on my amps, and pretty much I'm going to open that gap with my torch, with amperage. Just gonna open, I'm just gonna dip right in the middle, slow down. This is the slow steps, it's only like section, like from 10 o'clock all the way up to 12, that top section, that what is closed. Usually I go with the bigger tacks. Like I had a pretty good tacks actually, but there was the spots there where it was a high low and I didn't put tacks over there, and then it shrinks a lot. But even though it's doable, just go up on a heat and no worries, you don't have to use grinder. Especially if it's like, it's not in the field, it's in the shop, so if anything goes sideways, you can always grab a grinder. So now I'm ready for the hot pass. The hot pass is pretty much 160, 170. Hot pass pretty much straightforward, but it's also very important, especially with the bevel like this. It's easy to trap on the side, and you can if you don't burn very good, if you don't melt all that, it's easy to, you know, misstep sometimes. It depends from the angle as well of your bevel. Sometimes even hot pass, it's not that easy. But if you go up on amperage, you can't miss. That's why I like to have always a heavier root, because I like to run hot. And then I'm not worried about sog back inside. And okay, that's it. Hot pass is done, and I'm not gonna show you now. I'm gonna fill to flash. I'm gonna show you the process when I will finish that. Otherwise, it'll take long to watch this video. Okay, this is filter flash. Now, as I was mentioning, you didn't even notice when you're welding. Actually, when I show you on the root pass, you don't even notice how big high low is. And now I'm gonna show you right here on the outside. That's a lot. And there's like a couple spots like that. So the best way to fix this, I mean, you're not gonna fix it 100%, but you can like visually reduce to be like really visible. I'm gonna start on this side, actually on the higher side, with one bead for my cap, and then the other side or second bead that's gonna overlap with this one. I'm just gonna build it, like I'm gonna crank the heat, and I'm just gonna feed, like make it really thick. I'm gonna put lots of material Like, it's not that bad on the top, but on the, like, there's a little bit spots, but that's, I'm not too worried about that on the top section. But on the side, like 3 and 9 o'clock was really brutal. And that's it. This is the second pass. As I said, this one I really have to go like beef it up, so kind of visually, like the VT is okay, the weld is good, nothing's wrong, but you want to be, you know, just for the client. So yeah, that's it pretty much for this video, guys. There's always something new, there's always some challenges in the shop, in the field, with the material, with different pipes, different qualities. That's it pretty much. I hope you like it, enjoy it, hope you learn something new. I try to be more consistent with my videos, but more work is coming, so I hope. Don't forget to subscribe, like, share this video, hit that all bell icon button, so you're always up to date with all my new content. Thanks for watching and see you in the next one, guys.